a little bit offshore from places like Tampa.
There are plenty of them.
And you'll notice, we take a look at the wind fields that were already...
Hurricanes and tropical cyclones, tropical cyclones, the more generic name for hurricanes, are really important for the Navy. In fact, one could argue that they are the most critical environmental threat to the Navy in coastal and out at sea. And the Navy needs accurate forecasts of these because they have to make decisions about where to move their ships when they're in port, if there's a hurricane threatening, or where to route the ships to avoid any sort of hazardous conditions. I'm James Doyle. I'm the head of the Mesoscale Modeling Section here at NRL Monterey, the Marine Meteorology Division. And the Mesoscale Modeling Section is responsible for doing research on numerical weather prediction models that operate at very high resolution or small scale so that we can really resolve small scale aspects of the weather. So we're working very closely with our colleagues in other divisions at NRL. Example is the Oceanography Division, where we're coupling our mesoscale modeling system, which is called COAMPS, to ocean models, including the NCOM ocean model, which has been developed by our ocean colleagues, ocean expert colleagues at NRL Stennis, and also wave models as well. And we want to be able to properly account for the interactions that occur between the processes involving waves, the ocean circulation, and the lower part of the atmosphere. And these are all tightly coupled in nature, but in our models previously have not been tightly coupled. So they haven't been exchanging information about changes in temperature in the upper part of the ocean and how that might impact the atmosphere. So we think having that sort of tight coupling will help us improve our weather forecasts and our ocean forecasts for Navy operations. It's really benefited us greatly here at NRL to have expertise across the spectrum: oceanography, space science, electronic warfare division, other aspects of the problem, remote sensing. We've been able to benefit greatly through interactions with them, and I think they've greatly benefited through interactions with us as well. So it's really been a mutual benefit to have that capability within an organization to be able to work with such excellent scientists in this fashion.